Hello friends, let us see a program on how do we find the set bits in a given number. Now if a number is given as 21, we have to convert into binary, and in binary it is 10101, and we need to find the number of set bits. And how many set bits are there? This is the first set bit, second and three. Therefore the number of set bits, set means 1, is equal to 3, is equal to 3. Now how do we find this? Now, whenever we want to see it in a binary representation of a number, the first thing that comes to our mind is convert the number in binary representation. Now, how do we convert the number in binary? Say for example, this is 21, we divide it by 2, we say 2 tens are 20, remainder is 1. Now, this remainder is part of the binary number. Do we all agree? Yes, this remainder is a part of the binary number. Therefore, I need to check, is remainder equal to 1 or not? I need to check, is remainder equal to 1 or not? Yes, remainder is equal to 1. Therefore, you may increment the count. And you said 2, 5 are 10. What is the remainder? 0. Now, this 0 is again the part of the binary number, but it is a reset bit. Do not increment the count. Again we say 2, 2 are 4, remainder is 1, and whenever the remainder is 1, it is a part of the binary number, therefore you have to increment the count because it is a set bit. And we say 2, 1 are 2, remainder is 0, you don't do it, at last we have 1, this is again the part of the input, therefore there are 3 set bits. Now what we need to do over here, we need to divide the number by 2, 2, 2, 2 and 2, and whenever we get the remainder, right, we divide the number by 2 and take the remainder, and we check if the remainder is 1 or if the remainder is 0. If the remainder is 1, you have to increment the count, else you don't increment the count, and we proceed further till we get 0, till we get 0. Now, how do we write this code? We say hash include stdio.h. Next, you may write over here int main. What we need over here, we need a number n, which is a positive number. We take it as a positive number and we write int n, and you may read the value of n by saying scanf percentage %d ampersand n. Okay. Now what we need, we have to count the number of set bits, and whenever we start counting, normally count starts from 0. Therefore, let me say int count is equal to 0. Int count is equal to 0. And what we are interested in? We are interested in remainder. Now let's see how do we do it. We say while n not equal to 0, because till 0 we have to go on doing it. Say for example the value of n is 21. 21 is 10101. 21 is true. Now you need to get the remainder by dividing it by 2. Therefore we check if n modulo 2, the remainder is equal 1. Now you can use modulo operator or you can use the bitwise AND operator. How to use bitwise AND operator? Let us see later. 21 modulo 2 is equal to 1. 1 equal 1, yes. That means the count has to be incremented. And we say what? Count plus plus. Therefore, the value of count from 0 will become 1. Now this 21 should reduce to 10. How do you reduce to 10? You say 2 tens are 20, and we take quotient. And how do you divide a number by 2? You can say n is equal to n right shift by 1. N right shift by 1. Right shift by 1 is nothing but division by 2. Therefore, the value of n becomes 10. Integer by integer is integer. While 10 it is true, 10 modulo 2 is 0. 0 equal 1 is false. Do not say count plus plus. N is n by 2. N right shift by 1 is divided by 2. N becomes 5. Go back, 5 is true, 5 modulo 2 equal 1, yes, therefore you say count plus plus, count becomes 2, n is n by 2, n becomes 2, 5 by 2 is 2, integer by integer is integer, while 2 it is true, 2 modulo 2 is 0, 0 equal 1 is false, again you say n is n right shift by 1, 2 right shift by 1 is nothing but 1, 2 by 2, go back, while 1 it is true, 1 modulo 2 is 1, 1 equal 1, yes, you say count plus plus, count becomes 3. Again you say n is n right shift by 1. 1 right shift by 1 is nothing but 0. Go back. While 0 it is false, it comes out of this loop, and where is the answer stored? Answer is stored in a variable count, therefore we may print the count over here. We can say print percentage d slash n comma count. Now what is the value of count? The value of count is 3, and 3 is being printed. You may write return 0. Now what is this n modulo 2 equal 1? It means you are checking it is an odd number or not, right? And we know that we can use the bitwise operator to check if it is odd number or not. And how do we check bitwise operator? You can write n bitwise and 1 is equal 1. Or you may skip writing this equal 1 because 1 is taken as true and 0 is taken as false. Okay, let's trace it for number n equal to 3. Now 3 is 1, there are 2 set bits. 3 and 1 is 1, 1 is taken to be true, therefore count plus count becomes 1, n is n by 2, n becomes 1. Go back, 1 is true, 1 bitwise and is 1, count plus count becomes 2, n is n by 2, n is 0, and you print the value of count which is 2. Now this is how we find. Now what we are doing over here, if suppose the bit is 10101, we are checking each bit. You are checking this one. You are checking 0, 1, 0, 1. Each bit we are checking. Either it is 1 or it is 0. Right? It means if the number of, how many number of bits are there? It is for 21, it is log 21 to the base 2. It is in between 4 to 5. That means there are 5 bits. Therefore, you will check all the 5 bits over there. Even if it is 0, you are checking. But 0, we don't need it while we count the number of set bits. Therefore, how do we can overcome this? How we can only go to set bit? Only go to set bits means 1, 2, 3. This I have to do only in 3 iterations. Here I am taking 5 iterations. 5 times we are going it 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now, in the next algorithm, which is Brain-Cunningham algorithm, where what we will do, we will only go to the set bits and we see how we can find the set bits of a given number using the Brain-Cunningham algorithm. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please like it and write in the comment section whatever you feel about this video. And please subscribe to my channel and share the channel with your friends. Thank you.
For the online paid courses of C programming, data structures using C, and analysis and design of algorithms, you may contact at the given email ID and you may download the following app. The app link is being given in the description section. Thank you.